I've been teaching on prayer for the last 11 Sundays that I've stood before you. Why 11 Sundays? Am I going to stop? No. Not till you get it. Because prayer is essential. Prayer is relative to your spiritual life. Without you plugging in to the power source, you will never receive the light that you need in order to see your way through darkness. Amen. Just like these wall sockets here, they're power sources. But if you don't plug in, you will have no power to let your light so shine before men. Amen. That they would glorify your Father in heaven. Amen? Amen. I'm sorry, I had to put my suit jacket on, but I'm going to come out of it anyway. So. That's all for man. This is something that's so powerful, so significant. When God created man, he made man in his image and his likeness. Not flesh and blood, what you see, but that which you don't see. That's why your inward man had to be born again. Because flesh and blood, what you put on your flesh, what you look like, will never enter into the kingdom of God. That's why the wisdom of God, even though that it's not the same as the wisdom, it is greater. What does wisdom do? It shows us how to do what God called us to do. Amen? So now you're getting it what? Understanding, and then get what? Wisdom. Because wisdom allows you to apply what God has given unto you. Amen? There are some in the body of Christ that are forever learning, but never coming to the truth. But the Bible says that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. If you want to be free, you have to know truth. If you don't know truth, you can't get set free. You may come to a place like this and have some man or some woman pray for you. And that's only temporal, because healing is only temporal. Anything that you get in this life is only temporal. Only what you receive from God will last throughout all eternity. Amen? The money that you have in your pocket now is only temporal. Amen? You can't buy what our Father has done for you. And what he's done for you, he made you in his image and his likeness. But along with that, he gave you power, authority, delegated authority. Not all power, but some power. See, because all power belongs to God. And you have the authority to call what's in heaven to earth. Now, can't nobody get into your house unless they have what? Keys, right? So whoever you give a key to, they have the authority to come in your house. So God is giving you the keys to come into his house and get whatever you need. Amen? And the key to come to his house is prayer. Am I right about that?
Amen.
Do you understand that? One of the most powerful things in this life as spiritual people, as sons of God, we don't do. And that's pray. We look to lawyers, we look to doctors, we look to banks to satisfy us. Because we're trying to satisfy that which is spiritual with natural things. That's why God says, don't set your affections on things below, but set your affections on things above. Where cankerworm, thornworm, and rust do not what? Eat it away. Where your heart is where your treasure is also. So your treasure should be in heaven. Where it should be?
Amen.
So I don't want to have a form of godliness and deny the power thereof. And that's what happens to a lot of people in the body of Christ. They have a form of godliness. Well, I showed up to church now, Lord, you bless me. And God is not your servant.
Amen.
You are his servant.
Amen.
But what happens when you pray, God is giving you what he's already done in the earth. Finished, complete. But you're made in his image and his likeness, and he gave you authority and power to move in the earth. Well, why doesn't God just come on and take us out of here? It's because God doesn't move in the earth without you. The reason that the earth is in such bad shape is because we're not a praying people. You can blame gangs, you can blame the wars and all the rest of those things that have taken place. But if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves. Notice that that's a significant word, that you would humble. That means that you would submit yourself. And we're going to teach you some of that, how to do that and all the rest of these things, if we ever get to that part. But you have to learn how to give yourself completely to God. He's not a commodity, and you tell him, wait till I finish eating. You say, wait till I finish eating, or wait till I go to the movie, or wait till I return. You know, that's not God. God said for you and I to pray without ceasing. How would it to do? Pray without ceasing. For this is the will. Now, that's an important word, because your will is so important. Your will is so powerful, that it's so authoritative, God will not go against your authority. Y'all got to get that. God does not go against your authority, because he made you an authoritative people. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. So whatever you will, that he will do. See, now, the thing is that you are made according to his workmanship for his good pleasure, according to his will. How solid is that? How good is that? Then he says to you, likewise, in John, 1 Epistle, John, 5th chapter, if you ask anything according to my will, I will hear you. And if I hear you, you know that you have the prayer. I wish we had a praying people. I wish we had an understanding people. I wish we had a people that would submit themselves unto God. In Ephesians, the 3rd chapter, he talks about the empowerment that he gives us through prayer. Listen to these words. As Edie will just pray, read that whole chapter. I want that whole chapter read to you, so that you understand the empowerment and why you are who you are.
For this cause, I, Paul, the prisoner of Jesus Christ, for you Gentiles, if ye have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God, which is given me to you ward.
Wait a minute. That which is given to me, to you ward. So then, how many of you in here have power? One, two, three, four, five. Oh, okay, you're all going to raise your hands. See, you all have power, so how did you get it? It came through someone else. You understand? God doesn't move in the earth without you. I did not get saved until I heard the word of God through someone else. And then I didn't get saved until I, what did I do? Ask? What does that word ask mean? It means to pray. Until I prayed to the Father, and then the next thing I did, I submitted to him. And I said, whatever you say, that's what I'll do. I submit to your will. What happened to us after that? After the first time we accepted Christ in our lives, what happened? We become so mature, or we become so earthly good that we become no... Is it because we have a form of godliness now, and we deny the power thereof? You are a people of power, and the only way that you receive power is that you stay plugged into the source. How do you stay plugged in? That you have a relationship with God. How does that happen? You pray, then God tells you what to do in order to get it done. Amen? That's called revelation. See, you can pray the word of God, but the thing is that after you pray the word of God, then there are specifics that you have to pray. There's a specific need in your life. Amen? Like you may need a home, and you may want a home, but then you're going to have to tell me where the address is. How much it costs. Give you a home, it could be in 10 bucks too. It could be in a shooting gallery. See, but his will has to come. Then not only that, righteousness has to be before faith. You have to be in right standing with God. Amen? If you're not in right standing, then you cannot move by faith. All you're doing is moving by knowledge. Understand that? Now, it says this, that we must worship God in spirit. So if you're just worshiping God out of words that you read of the Bible, that's not spirit. Because in John 6:63, he said, my word is spirit, and it's life. In other words, every time you speak the word of God, it is creative. It begins to form and create that which you ask for. How do you know that, Pastor? Because in the beginning, God said, let there be light. Was that his word? Absolutely. He said. And then you, being just like him, can say. Am I in this all by myself today? Don't y'all shout me down because I'm preaching too good. It's all right. Amen. So you see how important it is that you give what you got. Because if you don't give what you got, you become a bad refrigerator. You can't keep it. Then some of you are freezers. You just keep it for yourself. Please read.
Where are we at?
Ephesians, the third chapter.
Verse 2. If ye have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God, which is given me to you, Lord, how that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery, as I wrote afore in few words.
So Paul is a praying man. He gave it to him by what? Grace. So then God gives him delegated authority to receive from heaven. Amen? What's the next verse say? The last verse you just read?
How that by revelation he made known unto me.
So then, the only way that I'm going to have a word for you, the only way I can really pray for you is that I get a revelation from God.
Yes.
You understand? I just can't spit on you and you're going to be healed. Amen? How do you think Jesus got a revelation? He did what we did, been doing all our lives in 1 minute because he spent time with the Father.
Yes.
Amen? He heard the revelation of the Father, spit in the ground, put it together with the dirt, and put it in the man's eyes.
Amen.
Was that revelation? Absolutely, because Jesus didn't know what to do. He only does what he's seen the Father do. Is that good?
Yes.
So then, you know, I seen a man put some woman in the stomach. I said, wow, why did he do that? Because God told him to punch in the stomach and she dropped the tumor.
Wow.
Would you do that? The only way I would do that is because I have a relationship.
Amen.
You got to have a relationship to receive the revelation of God. See? You are not supposed to be like another man. You're supposed to be like the man, Christ Jesus. That's why he made you in his image. Not your outward man, but your inward man. And out of the inward man flows the issues of the heart. Then he says in John 8 chapter, out of your belly shall flow rivers, and it's alive, it's powerful. And rivers that are flowing properly create electricity.
Yes.
Out of your belly, your innermost being is your spirit man. Praise God. Please read.
Whereby when ye read, ye may understand my knowledge in the mystery of Christ, which in other ages was not made known unto the sons of men, as it is now revealed unto his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles should be fellow heirs and of the same body, and partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel.
So in one man he made both twain.
Yes.
Amen. He brought us all together.
Right.
Amen. Amen. So it's been given unto, point to yourself, me, to understand the mystery of the gospel of Christ. So it's been given to you to know. How are you going to know? It's because God gave you the most powerful weapon, the most powerful being in the world, His Spirit, to bear witness with your spirit that you are the sons of God. And it does not appear what you shall be, but when you see Him. Where are you going to see Him at? You're going to see Him in His Word. You're going to see Him in prayer. And when you see Him, you shall be just like Him. Why? Because you're going to do what He told you to do. Are we doers? Are we just hearers only? You can affect your family. You can affect those things in your life. But you just can't focus on the problem. You must fight spiritually. Your embattlement is in the spirit. And how do you battle in the spirit? He showed you in Ephesians the 6th chapter that you put on the whole armor of God. And you stand not in the power of your might, but in the power of His might, with all manner of prayer and supplication. That's your battle. That's where you get the victory. That's where God fights for you. I don't fight with eating, and because eating made me mad. I fight with the spirit that made her mad, that made her do what she did. My battle is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, and rulers of darkness in high places. We're fighting each other. Why do you think families are divided? Because we're fighting against family.
Amen.
People don't understand that. If you would just get in the spirit, you would win the battle. My family wonders why I don't get upset when things take place. It's because my battle is not in the flesh. They may curse at me and things. I just look at them and say, you got a problem, bro. I got a problem. Amen. Amen. I know what to do for you. I got to pray for you.
Amen. Whereof I was made a minister according to the gift of the grace of God.
Whoa. A minister? Are you ministers? Are you ministers?
Yes.
Y'all not sure? When you know that you know somebody stands up and say, well, is your name Wong Lee Young? Absolutely. Just like that, you should know that you are the ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And why shouldn't you shout it out? Because God said, be not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because it is the
power.
See, the power is in your mouth.
Yes. Come on now.
The power comes from your spirit through your mouth.
Yes.
There's freedom in your mouth. There's prosperity in your mouth. There's healing in your mouth. There's deliverance in your mouth.
Yes. Amen.
Please.
According to the gift of the grace of God given unto me by the effectual working of His power.
See? But it doesn't become effectual till I release it to you. I would have never ever known the effectual working of the power of God until someone released it to me, or I got before God in prayer.
Amen.
Or got into His Word. That's why He says to you and I, to make the difference, to differentiate, man does not live by bread alone. You don't live by natural stuff.
Yes.
You live by spiritual.
Yes.
He said, except you eat this body and drink of my blood, you don't have no life in you.
Yes. Hallelujah.
That sounds like cannibalism, doesn't it?
Jesus.
But it's not.
Amen.
It's the Spirit of God.
Amen.
It's the Word of God. He's talking about eating the Word.
Yes.
Because Jesus came in the volume of
the
book.
Amen.
How do you eat His Word? You study His Word. You pray His Word.
Yep.
I wish I had a praying church right now.
Amen.
Amen.
The most powerful thing you can do. Money will never ever get what you can have with God.
Amen.
What He's already purchased for you. You are His people. purchased possession, that you would become just like him.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Who do you think you are? Are you the son of Ricardo or the daughter of Ricardo Cruz? Naturally you are, but spiritually you are a son of the living God.
Yes.
You came from God.
Yes. Amen. Hallelujah.
Man was the vehicle that he used to bring you here so that you could be just like him.
Amen.
Well, amen. What do you mean by that, Pastor? God didn't come down and have sex with my mother. No, he didn't. He used the man to do that. Man is just the agency through which he works through. He tied himself to you. Jeremiah 1:5. I knew you, Liz, before I put you in your mother's womb.
Yes.
And I ordained you to be a prophet to the nations.
Yes.
So why are you taking on an earthly nature of a palace that are not right?
Yes.
Oh, my father hurt me. They molested me. They kicked me out. I was an orphan. Blah, 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 blah. So what you're doing, you're not giving God the glory, you're giving devil the glory.
Yes.
I thought we were born again.
Amen.
Are you born again?
Yes.
Then you're the sons of God.
Hallelujah.
Please raise your hand.
Unto me who am less than the least of all saints is this grace given.
Why did he say that? Because he was the one that was going to kill everybody. He was the one to put people in prison.
Yeah.
Amen. Why did God pick me, man? I did all these things to his people. You can say the same thing. Well, why didn't God pick me?
Yeah.
I mean, because I live like, you know, the world. See, but he loved you while you were yet in your sin. He loved you before you sinned.
Amen.
You see?
Go ahead. That I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to make all men see what is the fellowship of the mystery, which from the beginning of the world hath been hid in God, who created all things by Jesus Christ.
So then you got to make people know the fellowship of the mystery. Where was it at? Was it hidden in Christ and God? So then you have to let people know that this is where you get it. You don't get it from a regurgitated meal on Sunday. You see? You get that fresh manna.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. It's fresh manna. It becomes fresh. I mean, every time I open the Word of God, I'm getting fresh manna. Why? Because before I even open the book just to read it, I say, Lord, give me the understanding.
Yes.
Give me the wisdom. Give me that anointing that's upon your Word. Then all of a sudden, revelation comes.
Amen.
Understanding comes.
Amen.
The authority comes. That's why I can stand bold and tell the devil, hell no. I'm not going that way. What I'm saying to you, you are a powerful people. Well, I pray all by myself. You're not by yourself. You got Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Wherever you go, they are with you. You're not by yourself. That's why it puts it in Romans, the 8th chapter. His spirit bears witness with your spirit that you are a son of God, made in his image and his likeness. And not only that, you have authority over everything. All natural stuff. So whatever's going on in your natural being is because it manifests in the flesh.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. So then whatever's manifesting in your flesh, you don't wrestle with that. You wrestle, you fight in the spirit.
Yes.
You know that it came from an evil spirit.
Yes.
And that evil spirit is trying to take you out.
Yes.
It's a thorn in the flesh.
Yes.
But God says when you are weak, I am strong. Why? Because he gave you the grace. He graced you that it wouldn't be sufficient in your life.
Yes. Amen.
To the intent that now unto the principalities and powers in heavenly places might be made known by the church the manifold wisdom of God.
So he's telling you that he's manifesting the things in the, that are spiritual, that are not right for you, that it may submit to the will of God in your life. See? See that? Is that right? Is that right?
Yes.
Okay.
According to the eternal purpose which he purposed in Christ Jesus.
So it will never ever fail. It's an eternal purpose. It's for as long as you live in this earth and on into the next
glory to God.
Glory. Amen. As long as you in this earth, it's going to last eternally because the gifts and callings of God are without repentance.
Thank you, Father.
Go ahead.
In whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him. Wherefore I desire that ye
faith. Wait. You got to get that. By the faith where?
In him. By the faith of him.
Yeah, it's not you.
Right.
See, if you have faith as small as a grain of mustard, that's all you need right now.
Right.
Oh, y'all didn't get that, man. Y'all didn't get that. It just went shh. If you have faith as small as a grain of mustard, that's all you need. Then it'll become great.
Amen.
Oh, I gotta know, I gotta understand this. Let me study the whole book, in fact, blah, 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 blah. And you didn't read the whole book and then you don't get it all because you didn't by faith receive what God had implanted in your life. See, if your prayer is effective, then it becomes fervent.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And it will avail.
That's right.
See, because what you do in secret,
right.
Somebody say secret.
Secret.
God will reward you.
Open.
In other words, you'll manifest it where? In the natural.
That's right.
Wherefore I desire that you faint not at my tribulations for you, which is your glory.
So Paul went through a whole lot of stuff. He got beat 5 times. He was in prison. He said, don't worry about that because it's to your glory. I went through those things and you can see that God will do what he said he will do.
Beautiful.
Even when I was in prison, the saints prayed and God opened the prison. I was in the inner prison. Amen? But here, Paul comes out and then Jesus knocks on the door and the disciples up in the upper room. So who's that? Don't open the door. You didn't believe what you prayed.
That's right. He said it. Did.
You didn't believe what you prayed. You should have known that he was coming.
Yes.
Please read.
For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man.
Wow, so he's praying that you would be what? Strengthened. By his power, his might, where? In the inner man, your spirit. Amen? Greater that is in you than he that is in the world. You're being just like him. You're praying. His word will change and affect that gang that's on Back Merlin.
Yes.
Those people that are selling drugs.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes, for Christ.
I told one pastor that belongs to the Fellowship of Churches, I said, look, I said, you have an opportunity to be in each ward of Atlantic City. You can set up a prayer place once a month in each one of those wards and have all those people that you have as pastors come and pray over that ward, that district. He said, well, what am I going to do? Some people don't want to pray in tongues. I said, don't pray in tongues, pray the word of God. So, see, it's religion that separates us. What you believe, what denominations believe, what philosophy is, has ruined the body of Christ. We can't even come together and pray because you believe a certain thing.
Jesus.
Go ahead and bake your cake. That's all the party you're going to have. That's all the blessing you're going to have.
That Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and length and depth and height, and to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God.
Speaking in tongues. Being filled is knowing the will of God.
Amen. Yes. 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 Trust in Him. Yes.
That's the smallest gift is speaking in tongues.
Come on.
Oh, hallelujah.
My God. See, some of us, we're too far from God. We are too far from God. You understand that? We're too far. You can jump. You'll be in heaven. This is the third. I'm in the first heaven. But you cannot reach the second heaven without getting in an airplane. And then you can't reach the holies of holies. You can't even get it by getting into one of those space shuttles or whatever it is. You can't even reach Him. But you can reach Him through prayer, praise God. You can reach Him through prayer. And your prayer will be faster than the speed of light. That old song, He touched me. He touched me.
Yes.
Something happened. And now I am no longer the same.
Yes.
He touched me. And now I'm every with all. I have to go. I have to sing to understand. But the reality is, man, that you can change and God will bless you right then and right there. But you wait for the manifestation. See, that's the problem, is that we live in a microwave society and we want it right now. But now is already here. But the thing is that God wants to see that you have submitted to His will. He's not going to give it to you just like that because you asked. No, you have to be right. See, we're too far off. In Matthew, the 7th chapter, says, God says, I never knew you. Depart from me. Well, I prophesied in your name. I did this in your name, but I don't know you. God would use a donkey.
Yes.
He'll use a raven. Why won't He use you?
Yes.
In order to get to that person He wants to touch.
True.
So it ain't you doing it. That's what He wants you to know. It's not you, but it's me.
Yes.
I'm working through you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Walking it, not talking.
Say that. Walk through me, Lord.
Walk through me, Lord.
How many people have you passed by that needed salvation?
Jesus.
How many people did you pass by that needed deliverance?
Yes.
How many people did you pass by that needed healing?
Yes.
Forgive me.
The Lord wants to know you. Then here's how He says that you should know Him. And this is how it should happen. Isaiah 26:3. I don't want to misquote it because my wife is not here. She'll probably listen to the tape and say, well, you said this wrong. You know that's the truth. That's my helpmate. She cracks a mean whip too, man.
Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace.
Whoa. What does that word peace mean?
Nothing.
Shalom? Right. Nothing missing? Nothing broken. I will keep you in perfect peace. In other words, you won't miss anything and nothing will be broken.
That's nice.
Right? Go ahead and read, please.
Whose mind is staying on thee because he trusteth in thee.
So then that's how you stay in direct connection. Whatever you're going through, don't give it everything. Give everything to the Lord. He says, cast the whole of your care upon me because I what? Care for you. How do you cast it? You pray.
Amen.
Is this okay?
Yes.
So then, focus not on the problem, the situation, but give it to God. Amen?
Amen.
So far from God. If we are fixed on stuff, then we forget about who God is. We fail to fulfill our sonship.
Excuse me. Whatever father did you know that if you heard his child crying, didn't run and see what was going on? Amen. That's a natural father. How much more will your heavenly father do that for you? So I'm telling you that it's a father-son thing. You are a son of God. Matthew, the 6th chapter, 9th verse, pray this matter. Our Father. Our Father. Our Father. He didn't say my Father. He said our Father. He's our daddy. And when we call, you best believe that he's going to answer. Praise be to God. Let's look at Matthew 3:15 for a second.
And Jesus answering said unto him, suffer it to be so now, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he suffered him.
Go ahead.
And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased.
So if he did that for him, you believe he did it for me?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Were you baptized? Were you filled with the Holy Spirit? Yeah. When did you get filled with the Holy Spirit? The moment that you accepted Jesus Christ into your life. The only thing is that what you have to do is start bringing it to maturity.
Amen.
How do you do that? It's through prayer and study of the Word of God. Can you imagine how many people have went to the altar, cried and prayed, Jesus, 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 and filled you with the Holy Ghost and all the rest of the things, and still don't have no power? Mm. Something's wrong with that, isn't it?
Yes.
So the power is not just in praying in tongues. The power is having a relationship with God.
Amen.
Amen.
I'll let you up with that suck a little bit because there's so much of that teaching that's still going on. But here's what I like what he said in Matthew 28, verses 18 to 20. I don't know how to finish this, but.
And Jesus spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth.
What is it? All power has been given unto Jesus. Is that right?
Yes.
So there's a transference of the anointing through the Spirit of God to you. He says, know ye not that you're brought with the price, therefore glorify God in your body? He that is joined unto the Lord is what? One spirit. 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 See? Spirit.
Jesus.
One.
Amen.
So the battle is with your spirit, making your flesh be under subjection to the will of God.
Yes.
If you are not able to control your flesh, then your flesh has control over you. Now, Jesus was in the garden and he said, the spirit's always willing, but the flesh is weak. And then here's the greatest man that ever lived was Jesus Christ. And he asked the Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me. Jesus said that. Was Jesus in his flesh? Nobody's going to say that, believe me. Yes, he was. But he said, he realized, nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. I dare you to do that. Try God. Say, not my will, but your will. Your will has to line up with God's will. Jesus proved it. Being man tempted in all points like we were, but yet without sin.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
He didn't let sin set in immediately. He realized, not my will.
Not your will. Jesus. Thank you, Father God.
Man. Be done. Then here comes the devil to tempt him in Matthew, the 4th chapter.
Right.
If you be the Son of God, turn these stones into bread.
Man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of thy mouth. And thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. So you are the sons of God. The devil shouldn't be able to tempt you. Are you sons?
Yes.
Yes.
You're good. That's right. Then he goes on and tempts him, says, look, go up on his pinnacle with me. I'll give you everything you see. He said, man, I know that my Father owns everything. How are you going to give me what already belongs to me? For it is written. You got to tell him what is written. When you tell him what is written, he has to adhere to what you say. Because you are a son. Say son.
Son.
I am.
A son.
Stand in the midst of a great people.
Yes.
I want to see manifestation.
Absolutely.
I want to see signs and wonders in your life.
Yes.
Can you imagine a preacher telling you that those things are not for today? See, you don't have to wait till the book of Revelations. You know, they always say, in the end, I win. No, I want to win right now.
Yes.
Because God is what? A now God. How do I know I win right now? Because he said in the beginning, I gave you the authority.
Amen.
He gave it to you in the beginning. Not in the end.
That's true.
Not till the devil raked you over the coals.
Right.
He wanted you to have the power and authority right now. When is God coming? Not right now. He's not coming. He's already here. How do you know where what that is here? Because the kingdom of God is in you.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
So, he said, all power in heaven and earth has been given unto me. Now you take it. Mm-hmm. You, say me.
Me.
And go.
And go.
And make disciples of all men, baptizing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Yes. You have to wait for a preacher to baptize somebody? I'll put you in a tub. I'll run a shower over you and baptize you.
Wow.
Well, let it wait till the right season comes and let it wait till we get the pool filled. That's religious. That's putting stuff before God. Colossians 1:27.
To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
That's it. That's the whole gist of it. Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Amen.
I'm gonna stop in a minute. Listen, the leper in Matthew the 8th chapter said, Lord, will thou heal me? The Lord said in return to him, I will, if you will. So he was telling that man, I don't know whether he was saved or not, but he's saying, if you understand my will and if your will lines up with my will, I will heal you. See, the Lord reigns upon the just and the unjust alike.
Amen.
But if your will lines up with God, do you wonder why the Jewish people are so prosperous? Because they know how to prosper in Christ Jesus. But they know the Old Testament. But God still honors his word, doesn't he?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
So if you would honor God's word, he'll do the same thing for you.
Amen.
If you would trust and obey God, he would set you free.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to end this. Here's how I end it. Let's go to 1 Epistle of John, the 5th chapter. And we'll pick this up 2 weeks from now, I guess. Whatever it may be. First John, First Epistle of John, the fifth chapter, we will begin at the 11th verse to the 14th verse.
And this is the record that God hath given to us, eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life.
God is saying to us here that just as you believe in your salvation, believe that when you pray, I will answer you.
Amen.
How many of you know that you're saved?
Amen.
Then if you know that, you know that you're saved. You know that you're going to go to heaven. Then the same way when you pray, know that God's going to answer you. Yes. I mean, he says this right here. Listen to it.
This is the record that God hath given us to us, eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. And this is the confidence that we have in him.
See that? Now he's bringing it to you now. He's bringing it to you now. So then if you have confidence enough in Jesus Christ to believe that you're saved, you should have the confidence to do what? Read this, please.
And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything.
What does that word ask mean?
Pray.
Pray. This is the confidence that we have. If we pray,
yes.
Go ahead.
Anything according to his will.
His will.
He heareth us.
Amen.
His will,
not
your will.
And if we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire.
Right. Is that beautiful?
Hallelujah.
Is that beautiful? Amen. How many of y'all have become praying people? Amen. And we will change our world. We will affect our world for Christ. Listen, and I'm not telling you that you have to pray 1 hour. You understand? But you got to be effectual. Amen. Before you put your feet on the ground, you say, thank you, Lord, I got another day. You know? And you just continue to pray from that moment forward. Amen. Praise be to God. My God, my God, my God, my God. Oh, man, I have so much I could give you all, but I'm going to stop because I'm going to wear you out. Let's go to Genesis 15:6, and I'll finish. I think, God, you need to hear this. So then, Abraham believed what God said, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. So then, if you believe what God says, it will be counted to you as righteousness. If you believe what God says, it will be counted to you. He'll seal it by his Spirit. Receive that. Oh.